obviously so noise equivalent bandwidth. So we already know that the mean square value of the output noise voltage of a system with transfer function h of omega is given by 1 by pi 0 to infinity. So si of omega, so mod h of omega whole square d omega. So here, for a particular frequency omega naught, we can evaluate the h of omega naught. At a particular constant frequency omega naught, we are finding h of omega naught and take the reciprocal of it. Then multiply with 0 to infinity. So this particular quantity is 1 divided by h of omega naught. So what is this? This is a constant. And after integration, this integral reverses to a constant. Because we are, this is a function of omega, this is also a function of omega. We are integrating with respect to omega and substitute the limits. After integration, this will be a constant and that is multiplied with another constant. Why? Because this omega naught is a constant. So before that, we assume this SI of omega is the power spectral density of the input noise voltage, and the assumption is that this input noise voltage is the thermal noise or thermal noise. So if it is thermal noise, what is the power spectral density? Is 2 kT. So voltage, the power spectral density of the thermal noise voltage is 2 kT into R. So with the assumption that the temperature is kept constant, so this will become a constant. We already know that for all the practical purposes, we let the power spectral density of the thermal noise voltage or thermal noise current is assumed as constant. So let this is some k, a constant k. Here k is not the Boltzmann constant, don't get confused with this k and this k. We write differently. So we are letting the power spectral density is constant. So if you let the power spectral density is constant, then we can write this as that k divided by pi is 0 to infinity. So mod h of omega whole square d omega. So this is the mean square value of the output noise voltage of a particular system with transfer function h of omega. The constant divided by pi 0 to infinity mod h of omega whole square d. That is, with the assumption that is the power spectral density is constant, we can easily find the mean square value by simply finding the area under the mod h of omega whole square power, then multiply with k by pi. Here, at a particular omega naught, now we evaluate the h of omega naught value and divide with that we got the reciprocal of that value, 1 by h of omega naught. Then 0 to infinity is mod h of omega whole square d omega. So this particular quantity, that is area under mod h of omega whole square function, and that is multiplied with h of omega, is called as the noise equivalent bandwidth of a system. So this is the definition of the term noise equivalent bandwidth. So noise equivalent bandwidth is a constant. So that is defined as 1 by h of omega naught multiplied with 0 to infinity mod h of omega whole square d omega. That is, this is the equivalent noise bandwidth, noise equivalent bandwidth is also called as equivalent noise bandwidth at omega equivalent to omega naught. At a particular frequency, omega equivalent to omega naught, the noise equivalent bandwidth is designated as W of W O naught. This is a capital W that is given by this much. So with this definition of the equivalent noise bandwidth or noise equivalent bandwidth, we can relate the mean square value and this. Is it? So from this, can I write this W naught multiplied with h of omega naught is equivalent to 0 to infinity, so mod h of omega whole square d omega. Is that right? So therefore, what is the mean square value now? Mean square value of the output noise voltage of the system that we consider is equivalent to k by pi. Here, k by pi multiplied with this. What is this 0 to infinity mod h of omega whole square d omega is equivalent to? So, omega naught, sorry, W naught into h of omega. So obviously, this is a constant, is it right? Because k is the constant, pi is constant, W naught is also a constant, and h of omega naught is also a constant. Therefore, the mean square value of the output noise voltage of the system that we consider is constant. Or this is the relationship between mean square value of the output noise voltage and the noise equivalent bandwidth, W naught. So what is the significance of this particular W naught? What is the significance of the noise equivalent bandwidth? So by observing this equation, can you tell? So W naught is a bandwidth and it is multiplied with h of omega naught. What is h of omega naught here? What is h? H of omega? H of omega is the gain. Is it the frequency or gain of the system? So h of omega naught indicates the gain at a particular frequency. So this h of omega naught is the gain of the system at a particular frequency omega naught. So gain, and this is the bandwidth. So gain bandwidth, the product of gain and bandwidth, which is equivalent to constant. Is it right? I think you might have studied the relationship between the gain and the bandwidth of the system. The gain bandwidth product is constant. Is it? So here we are defining the noise equivalent bandwidth, that is W naught, and the gain of the system at a particular frequency omega naught is given as h of omega naught. So therefore, this k by pi is a constant, and W naught into h of omega naught, that is also constant. That is, the gain bandwidth product is becoming constant. Here, if you consider two different systems, let let this is one amplifier. The magnitude squared go like this. I think you might have studied the frequency response of the amplifier. So here, at a particular frequency, omega naught, let the gain is mod h of omega naught. Just take this as magnitude power. Yes, so what will be the bandwidth? We take the half power bandwidth. So if we take the half power bandwidth, that is the, we consider the frequencies at which gain is 1 by root 2 times it of the maximum. That is called the half power bandwidth. Therefore, here this is, this can be considered as the bandwidth, W0. Now, if you consider another amplifier, the magnitude response h of omega, and that is looking like this. So let here, so this is the ideal response. Okay. It is almost constant. Okay. Here it is not constant. Let this is the bandwidth, equivalent noise bandwidth, and this is the value at omega equivalent to omega. Therefore, this is the mod h of omega. Here the significance of this particular noise equivalent bandwidth in case of the amplifier, we take the two different amplifiers with this frequency response and this response. Here the noise equivalent bandwidth is W0. Here the noise equivalent bandwidth is W0. So if you consider two different amplifiers with two different frequency responses, the significance of this W0 is that indicates the area under this frequency response is equivalent to the area under the frequency response of this amplifier. That indicates if you transmit this noise voltage through a band pass filter, the frequency response of the output noise signal will be like this. So this is equivalent to transmitting the noise voltage through an ideal band pass filter. So that's why if you evaluate the area under these two curves, that will be equivalent. That is, the area under this curve and the area under this curve will be same. If you transmit the noise voltage through a band pass filter, the frequency response or the frequency domain representation of the output noise voltage look like this. Otherwise, if you consider two different amplifiers, here the system that we consider, we are assuming the system with transfer function h of omega as the noiseless elements. So if you assume that particular system is an amplifier, if it is an ideal amplifier, so definitely there are no elements of the noise. Okay. Then find the frequency response for two different amplifiers. Okay. And if you let the equivalent bandwidth of those two amplifiers is same, that is W0, then the area under those two curves that are drawn will be same. So that indicates if you transmit the noise voltage through a band pass, ideal band pass filter, okay, the response of the two different amplifiers is same as that of the response of the ideal band pass filter. Okay. So in that context, we calculate the equivalent noise bandwidth, and that is the relationship between the mean square value of the output noise voltage of the system and the equivalent noise bandwidth. Understood this?